Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be explaining you Doppler effect in great details. Here, I'll be also deriving equation of frequency deviation because of Doppler effect. In radar engineering, Doppler effect plays very essential role. Based on Doppler effect, radar can identify motion of the target. As if target is there in motion, means as if target is having some velocity. Then that velocity calculation that can be done with the use of Doppler effect. So first of all, you need to understand what is Doppler effect. See, Doppler effect explains you motion of the object. As if source or observer is there in motion, then there will be resultant change in transmitted wave frequency. That is referred as Doppler effect. Let me explain you that by a few case studies that will give you more clarity. Here, let us assume we are having radar system, and here target is moving towards radar system. So you can observe this target that is moving towards radar system. Here, as if I say this radar is transmitting frequency that is FT, and here echo signal that is having frequency which is FT plus FD, then based on this frequency deviation, radar can identify velocity of this target. And radar can also explains that this target is moving towards radar. So based on frequency deviation, radar can identify motion of the target. Let me take another scenario. So here we are having radar system, and here target is moving away from the radar. So here, as if radar is transmitting frequency that is FT, then reflected echo signal that will be having negative deviation. So based on negative deviation, radar can identify motion of the target. Radar can calculate velocity of this target, as well as radar can explains that this target is moving away from the radar. As if target is stationary, in that case, radar will be observing there is no deviation in between transmitted and echo signal. So here, based on frequency deviation, radar can identify direction of the motion as well as velocity calculation. So now I'll be going to derive equation of frequency deviation based on velocity of the target. To understand frequency drift due to motion of target, let me consider one practical scenario. Here you can observe we have radar system and target is moving towards radar. Let us assume target is moving by velocity V towards radar system. As if target is moving towards radar system, then there will be frequency deviation in between transmitted and reflected echo signal. Here transmitted signal that is having frequency FT and reflected echo signal that is having frequency FT plus FD. So we are dealing with to identify this deviation in frequency FD. Here, as if target is moving towards radar system, at that time this deviation will be positive, and as if this target is moving away from the radar, at that time this deviation will be negative. To understand this calculation, you need to understand how signal is traveling over here. See, signal is transmitted by this radar, and that will be traveling by distance r up to this target. After distance r, there will be reflection from the target, so signal will again move back to radar over here. So in total, signal traveled over here will be r plus r, means 2r. So signal is traveled by 2r distance over here. Now we need to understand how deviation is happening. See, deviation is happening because of motion of target. Here, as this target is moving, there will be change in phase of signal. So first of all, you need to understand what is the total phase of signal. So here, for that, you need to understand signal. See, signal will be sinusoidal signal over here. Now, with signal, if you talk about wavelength, then wavelength is lambda over here. And with lambda wavelength, in total phase, that will be 2 pi radian, right? So for lambda wavelength, phase is 2 pi, then how much phase will be there with 2 hour distance, so that we can easily calculate. See, for lambda wavelength, if you talk about phase, then that is 2 pi. Then for 2 hour distance, what is the phase? That phase will be, let us say that is pi, then that will be this 2r divided by lambda into 2 pi, right? So now we have total phase of signal. See, this phase that is varying because of velocity of target. Let us say that variation in phase that is happening with respect to time because of motion of target. So that is d phi by dt. And that rate of change of phase, that is omega d over here, right? So here, this phase that is changing due to motion of target. And here, omega d, that is rate of change of phase with respect to time. And omega d is how much? 2 pi fd, right? Where this fd, that is deviation in frequency, right? So now we just need to substitute this phi, which is 2r by lambda into 2 pi in this equation. So let us differentiate this d by dt of phase, that is 2r by lambda into 2 pi, that is equals to 2 pi fd. Now here, if you observe, see this 2 pi and this 2 pi, that is constant, that is getting cancelled. And if you observe 2 by lambda, see, wavelength is constant. Wavelength of signal will never change, right? So 2 by lambda, that is constant. And here we will be having dr by dt, that is equals to fd. Now, what is dr by dt? Dr by dt is velocity of target. See, here, as if target is moving in this direction, right? Then, but obviously, this range will change with respect to time. So rate of change of range with respect to time, that is velocity of target, right? So here we have dr by dt, that is velocity of target, right? So your equation of deviation of frequency, now that will be 2v by lambda. So based on frequency deviation, one can calculate velocity of target, right? So deviation of frequency, that is 2v by lambda. And this is what happening as per Doppler's effect, right? And based on this deviation of frequency at radar, one can identify what is the velocity of target. And this deviation will be positive as if target is moving towards radar. And as if this deviation is negative, in that case, radar can identify that that target is moving away from the radar, right? So based on deviation, radar can identify velocity of target. I hope you have understood this. Still, if anything that you'd like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.